Okay, in this video, I'm going to show you how to deploy the Hadoop Insight machine learning server with the rServices cluster to complete the final project, which is to create the prediction model to help in the loan approval. There are a few tasks that we need to do to complete this project, but first, of course, we need to deploy the cluster. And I'm going to show you in the first part of the video the five tasks, creating the virtual network, and then as I mentioned here, until the fifth task, yeah, which is uploading the R script. Okay, so I will start with the task one, creating the virtual network.
After log onto the Azure portal, then we create a new resource, select the networking, and then choose the virtual network. And then choose your plan, your subscription. I'm going to create a new resource group for this. Can be any valid name, the resource group. For example, I use Ryan HCI 0000RG. RG for the resource group. So it's up to you. The name is up to you. Then I give the name for the virtual network. This one is also up to you. Okay, and then after that, choose the region. I will choose the Southeast Asia. And then assign the default IP address /16. I delete the default subnet and create the my subnet. I call it the Ryan HCI 000 subnet. And then choose the /24 IP address 10.1.1.0/24 for the subnet. So I'm going to connect my cluster to this subnet later. Then click next. Don't change anything. Yeah, validation successful. Then click create. It will take very fast. Yeah, only a few seconds. Then the resource is created already. So we go check, yeah, so the virtual network is created already. So
okay, you have seen how to create the virtual network, and at the same time I also create one virtual subnet, and we going to use this virtual subnet to connect to the machine learning server that we going to create in the next step, yeah, the task number two. So task number one is done already.
We click to create a new resource and then choose from the analytics the template. Choose the Azure HD Insight. And we select the subscription and then choose the existing resource group which was created for the virtual network just now. And then assign a cluster name. Okay, so in this example, I created the cluster name with Ryan HCI 000CL. Choose the region, Southeast Asia. Okay, and then after that, choose the cluster. This is important. You have to choose the cluster type, the HD Insight, the ML machine learning server with R services. And then assign the password, unique password. Must meet the minimum requirement for the password length and then the password complexity. So I use this for the password. I suggest you write somewhere, because if you forgot, then there will be a lot of trouble to recover the password. Okay, create a storage account. So just assign any valid storage account. I use a SA as a suffix to indicate it is a storage account. Okay, check everything. Okay, yeah, we don't need to modify any other setting from this page other than storage account. Then for the virtual network, we connect to the previous subnet that we created earlier in the task one. We change the size because we want to save the money, save the credit. Yeah, change the worker node just to 1, from 4 to 1. So the cost is cheaper, about $3.4 per hour, $3.40. So first, it will do the verification. Yeah. So this experience a few times. Yeah, looks like this is intermittent. So sometimes okay, sometimes not. Yeah. So in this case, then I just go back to the previous page in the basic. Try to rename the cluster. Yeah, I did that a few times, and I found after a few times, then it successfully deployed. Yeah. So I go back to the initial page in the cluster name, and then change the name of the cluster. Okay, so this is a trial and error, but I hope you didn't experience this. So whenever everything smoothly completed, then it will pass the validation and successfully create. Yeah. Okay, I just repeat again this task, check all the name all valid. Yeah. When you check for the second time, then you will get the error message that the class name is invalid. That's possible because previously the cluster name was submitted and then going to be created. Maybe the name was allocated already. Yeah, so you saw this. I click the basic. Yeah, showing the name is invalid. Okay, I just try to change the name to other name by modifying the number or adding any character as long as the validation pass like this. Yeah. So you have the green check marks yeah, that the name is valid. Then I try to redeploy again. Yeah, still have an error. Okay, then try to go back again, change again the name. Yeah, maybe change the number from 0 to 9, for example. Okay, yeah, so with the process is successful this time. Okay, looks good. Yeah, okay, validation succeed. Yeah, I don't know what is the problem. Yeah, but I discovered then after I try a few times, then it's passed the validation and can successfully create a cluster. Okay, so it takes maybe about 15 to 20 minutes for the overall process to create. Yeah, first it will create the storage account. Yeah, and then after that it will create the cluster. So wait a while until this I speed up the video, but the overall process may be taking about 15 to 20 minutes.
Okay, so after few times trial and error, you have seen I have successfully deployed the Hadoop inside machine learning server with the Azure services in the my Azure subscription. So this task is completed. Yeah, and then you have also seen that I have connected my server with the virtual network that was created earlier. The next task that I'm going to do is to deploy the required R packages. Yeah, because the R services that built in inside the this cluster does not have this hash function, SM binning, and also the Spark LYR R packages that we need for the analysis. Yeah, so in the next task, I'm going to show you how to deploy this using the script action.
There are three R packages that we need to upload because this is not available in the R services. So first we need to access the cluster and then using the script action. So this is the way we deploy to the R server the packages that we're going to use. Yeah, so follow this template. The name of the script action is the install R packages. So choose from the list the custom package, then rename. Yeah, install rpkgis, then the script URL you copy from the link that provided there. Okay, then I choose the component head, the worker, and the edge, and then I copy pass the parameter tree name of the rpkgis. Okay, so once this completed, then I submit there. Yeah. So this process also will be taking about a few minutes to complete. Yeah. Then we're going to monitor. Yeah, you saw that I already fast forward the video. Yeah, so this completed already. And then what you going to continue is to check, yeah, that those packages are already installed in the R services. Okay, so open the cluster, and then after that open the R studio. First we log on with the username admin, and then the password is the same password, just know that you take note, yeah, this. This is first to log on to the UI. Yeah. Then to log on to the R server, you use the SSH user. The password is the same. Okay. Then you will see the R server environment. So we check the packages. Then verify that the hash function, smbinning, and also the Spark LYR already installed correctly. So that's the
okay. You have seen how I deploy the R packages using the script action, and then verify that those three packages are installed in our R studio. And then the next task is we're going to upload the dataset that we're going to use. Yeah, there are four dataset: the loans and borrower CSV, 10,000 rows, and the loans prod and borrower prod, 22 rows for the testing. Yeah, so. The next task is uploading this loans and borrower dataset. You can upload directly in the storage container, yeah, inside the storage account, or you can also upload using the Azure Storage Explorer. Yeah, but you need to install the Azure Storage Explorer if you want to use that. So I'm going to show you the way, simple way, yeah, to upload directly to the storage account container.
Okay, so from the R Studio, we go back to the cluster management console, then after that look for the storage account, and then select the storage account. After that we select the container, yeah, from the container. Then after that we're going to upload the dataset. Yeah, select the one that we use, so click the upload button, and then from the files menu, we choose the four CSV file. You can select together all of four of them, and then click advanced to designate the set the folder target, yeah, which is capital L loans/data capital D. This is case sensitive. Then click upload. Yeah, then verify it create the folder name loans capital L. Yeah, and then inside subfolder data with capital D. Okay, then now you have the data set is already uploaded. Yeah.
Okay, so I have shown you how to upload the loans and borrower the data set, yeah, to the storage account. So the next step is to upload the R script.
Okay, we go back to the R studio, and then in the files, then we're going to click the upload, and then choose a file, select the zip file that contains all the R script that already been prepared, open, yeah, then automatically it will extract the
okay, so you have seen how to upload the R script, so you don't have to extract the zip file. You can directly upload the zip file into the R studio, then it will automatically extract it in the R studio. Yeah, okay, this step completed. Yeah, so that's the end of this first part of the video. Thanks for watching.